these hellstorms are. They can be shut down. There's another one forming over a resistance black site in Sardinia. Our chief occultist, Ephraim Schweiger, is on the ground gathering data. But we just lost radio over the whole region. Get in there, secure Schweiger's intel, and then stop that hellstorm.
You're too late. Schweiger and his team have left for the base. He said they had to go immediately in order to prepare for the hellstorm.
Blame the damn boat. This is as fast as we could get here.
I tried to make him wait. I told him this whole place is swarming with dead. They'll eat you alive. But he wouldn't listen.
Welcome to Sardinia, guys. Vlad here with the third mission in... Zombie Army 4 Dead War. We have successfully escaped the previous mission, if you remember, from the walkthrough I just uploaded. And right now we are playing mission 3. For those of you who are new to this channel or you didn't see the previous parts, we are playing this awesome zombie shooter on hard. You can see in the upper left corner, and we are going solo, which means that we won't receive any help from anyone except our trustworthy weapons. So welcome back, and let's check, first of all, I'm going to check these perks over here and my weapons, because we have masteries on two of them. This is awesome, truly awesome. And here is the platinum skin. I also have the platinum skin for this MP44, and as you can see, my shotgun over here is now has increased damage, increases actually damage to our secondary weapons. This is great. And this one also has increased damage. Right now, unfortunately, I don't have other weapons except this one. I'm going to use the trench gun once more. We used it before, and I'm going to use it for this mission as well. As for hopefully we can get a mastery on the trench gun, and also on the pistol, and this will allow us to unlock a new trophy. So, as I was saying, we had quite some time in the previous mission, and right now we are going to take on the third one, hopefully without incidents. let's check the perks. We could use this, definitely. Yes, yes, we could use this. And if we place another three wow, you can. No, actually, no. There are two different. There are two different perks. I thought these two, the first and the last, are the same, but they are not. Anyway, so we are ready. If we complete this mission with all gold perks, you see, I've just equipped, I'm going to unlock a new trophy for doing this. We are... So let's start the mission first, and then I will explain for those of you who have just joined us how things go. Let's get a med kit. We have it. So we are good. As I was saying, this walkthrough is on hard mode, but I already completed the game once, so I know what to do and what to expect. Also, I already got all collectibles, so we are not going to cover them in our walkthrough. Challenges regarding the challenges, each each mission or chapter in a mission has a challenge. This one over here can be easily completed. We are going to cover it as well, but not all of them, unfortunately, can be completed on hard difficulty. And I'm going to tell you which one can, because there are some time challenges that well, basically we reduce our score, and we don't want that. We want to reach the highest score possible. This door moved. The trap door moved. I think there is a guy down there. Anyway, so as you can see, with this weapon, I already know what to expect from this this mission. So I kind of pick this weapon specifically to go through it faster. But as you saw from the previous walkthrough, zombies die. They don't die easily on hard difficulty. So this is why some walkthroughs I'm going to upload are quite long. This was another screamer that we know. It's pretty dangerous. What just happened? Oh man, there's more than one. The difficulty level also changes the number of enemies you are about to face, and I've noticed that some of the enemies that usually appear later in the game, they appear earlier on hard mode, and this makes the whole game even more interesting than playing on medium difficulty or easy. I don't think there are actually players who could actually enjoy this game on easy difficulty. I mean, there is no challenge whatsoever. So I decided, while most YouTube channels upload walkthroughs on medium or even easy, I saw some of them uploading walkthroughs on easy mode. I don't actually understand why they do that. I mean, there is no point in playing a game if there is no challenge in it. But this is my opinion, so obviously other YouTubers are free to do whatever they want. I, on the other hand, like to see how things play out on let's say a more professional mode. So right now, as you can see, we are in a forest. This mission, most of it takes place in this forest, and if I remember correctly, the final stage, or I don't know, let's say boss fight, although it's not a boss fight, it's quite accessible on medium. But then again, I said the same thing about the last mission. In the last chapter in the second mission, and it wasn't what I expected to be. So right now we are taking out. We are taking out these guys over here. Okay, we are good. Oh, there is another one moving. Stay down. And let's see what's in this cabin. Maybe. Oh, there it is. We have some ammo. Other than that, nothing. And in this cabin there is a collectible. Oh, here is something funny. Yeah, it won't move. This is odd. Oh, but it does. Notice that the light is removed. There are several weird things happening in this game. Hopefully I'll be able to show you if I remember their locations. Most likely I will. There are some strange dolls, and if you you will find typewriters, and if you use them you can actually use some of the items such as toilets, robinets, typewriters, and if you do that you receive strange messages. I don't know, from the underworld. not really sure who's actually sending those messages, but it's pretty they are pretty fun to find and use those items.
Bruno, you got a lot of zombies, but no sign of Schweiger. You heard from him at all?
I'm afraid not. Since they reached the base, it's been a radio silence. Perhaps once you're closer, you'll be able to pick up their signal.
Bastard shot!
Let's perform a takedown on this guy, because I kind of like to keep my my health bar above normal. This is it's pretty dangerous, because right now if you noticed when I started the game, I kind of ditched the second chance perk. That perk is similar to the one from Borderlands, which gives you another wave, a second wave, a second chance if you kill an enemy within a given time once you are downed. So if you do that, you basically get a second chance. But I kinda ditched that one, because I want to finish this level with 3 golden perks. This guy is kinda crazy. So let's try to snipe him. Okay, here it is. And there you go. And I'm going to try and snipe these guys as well. Aim for their heads a bit. Oh, sorry. That was an eye shot. Not a headshot, but an eye shot. But I consider it a headshot because, you know, the eyes are in the head. We are done. Let's refill our health for good. Perfect. And right now we are going to go towards that bunker in the distance, and let me check. So we have a divine grenade there in the lower right left corner, and I need we have an electric grenade, divine, and bait. None of them will serve our purpose. Because, well, there is something we are going to encounter after this wave of zombies. And I kinda needed several mines. Okay. Hopefully we will have enough ammo to get all of them. No, that's okay. Let's do this with our trusty shotgun. So there you go. Now I'm kinda worried of what's going to happen next if I don't have or if I don't find a mine, at least one. I need at least one teller mine for the guy who's waiting me on the other side of this bunker. And we have divine grenades only. This is not good. Maybe here? Okay, we are going to take the incendiary S mines. Oh, come on. Okay. You'll see in a moment why I need these mines. Although, honestly, I needed what I needed was a teller mine. Because over here, there is a guy. A pretty crazy guy. Here it is. So I needed a mine for this this idiot to place it on the ground over there where this zombie keeps keeps moving, and take out that truck immediately. That truck is actually dropping. Dropping zombies. So right now I'm going to place that incendiary mine, although it will not help me too much, especially if this guy steps on it, or this one. As you can see, I'm trying to protect it. May not succeed. Oh well. Then we are going to take that truck the hard way. Let's place another one here. Oh, come on, stay down. This is the path that truck is going to follow. And if I manage to take it out with a teller, normally with a teller mine I was telling you about, the truck would be destroyed in one shot, but since I have incendiary mines, I'm not sure it's going to work. We'll just wait for it here and see. You can see he's about to appear. Let's see what happens. I'm going to take cover behind this. Let's see. Yeah, so that didn't work. This is not good. We are going to have a rough time with this truck. Okay, so basically I've just put a bullet in that guy's mouth and it exited on the other side. That's what I did. Let's see if we can move around this area and maybe we can find a mine. I could really use it. Maybe here? No, this is a big grenade. Can't use that. Because I cannot, obviously I cannot bait a truck. We can obviously try try destroying that truck with our gun, but there is no need to take unnecessary risks over here. And if I already know how to deal with it, a mine is all I need. Okay, so we have some guy with a machine with a... who is shooting me. Not sure where it is. There are two of them. I know that there are two of them, but I can't remember where. Okay, so I think we are going to try and take over here. No, we are going to try and take out the truck the hard way, because obviously the zombies will not stop spawning as long as that truck is moving around. So. We have a Gatling gun over here. Let's see if we can get close to it and use it on... Oh, there it is. Okay, perfect. Okay, perfect. Thanks God. Okay, this is it. Let's heal on. Come on. on this guy. So as I said, I will not, we will not focus on collectibles in this walkthrough, because I already uploaded all guides. So if you're watching this walkthrough hoping to find the collectibles, well, this will not happen, because you can see over here I already have all of them. But they are uploaded on YouTube. You can this is sweet. You can find them in the description. There is a playlist with all missions and all chapters. Just check the one you need, and you'll find all of them. There are three achievements and three trophies for finding and collecting all documents, comic pages in the game.
It seems you need to refuel the opening mechanism.
Let's hydraulic fluid flow. There is another artillery flare. Yes, these are very powerful, that's why I'm picking them up. The artillery flares are very, very powerful. Most likely you'll see me using one of them. The moment we open those doors. So this is the, as you can see, right now I'm trying to get 30 kills with the handgun, the pistol, because this is one of our challenges, and as I said, we are going to try to complete as many as possible, and this one is pretty easy. Here they are. Okay, so let's get more ammo and back to our camp. We have to fill these cans. Actually, there is only one can. To fill this can in three different spots. Whenever we wait for a can to fill, more zombies will appear. We have 16 kills. Some headshots. Those are great too, because luckily I already upgraded my what to red gunner. Who said something about the turret gunner? This is fun.
There goes one turret gunner.
So we have 23. 7 more and we are done with the challenge. Let's wait for the can to fill and get ready for our friends. As I told you, those some suiciders are pretty great, as you can use them in your advantage. Notice that when you use the bait, the zombies will ignore you. So if you have a suicider like this one heading towards the area where the zombies are, well, kill all of them. and you will get a better score, which is great. But this means that you need the bait grenades, and the bait grenades can be found everywhere, so it depends. Okay, almost done. These three guys, and we should be good. Let's see what's inside this yellow box. Might be an attachment. Oh, we've got a preacher. So this preacher, if you didn't check the first part of my walkthrough, this preacher is a unique weapon, meaning that you only have, as you can see, 16 bullets for it. And once you use them, well, the weapon is useless. And as you can see, right now I'm going back to get my preacher. Not sure where I left it. Oh, here it is. And more suiciders. Okay. Oh man, there is a general who is empowering. Let's see where it is. Oh, there it is. This guy over here is a commander, not a general, sorry. Is empowering the zombies. They become more aggressive and faster. So it's pretty dangerous. Kind of a support unit, if you like. And goodbye. Okay. So late. This is where we are going to drop the preacher. I might return for it. Let's check the challenge. So 23. 24. Let's put the canister over here and recharge. Actually, stock on ammo for our pistol or handgun, so we can get the remaining kills. Oh, this was very close. Man, there's a lot of suiciders. Ooh. Oh. I'm trying to get rid of the suiciders and also keep some of the zombies alive, because I still need 5 of them for the challenge. Let's see if we can get it. One. And this is how we complete this challenge. Oh, we did well because we also unlocked a new perk. This is awesome. So far, so good. Indeed, we don't have any more medkits, but hopefully we are going to succeed. Right now, I'm going to place this canister over here and return after my my preacher. You will see in a moment why. As I said, guys, I already played this part, and know what's going to happen. Hopefully, I remember where I left my preacher. It was around here, somewhere around here. Yeah, if I can find it, that's okay. There is a new type of zombie. Oh, here it is. There is a new type of zombie. Those seven slugs or bullets I have in this preacher are pretty important for me right now. There are four dangerous enemies we are going to face behind those doors, and well, I kind of rely on my on this this weapon right now, and there they come. I'm also going to Oh, there are only three? No, there are four, obviously. So I'm going to throw everything I got on these guys. Let's see if I can get... So we have some grenades. Get at least one of them.
Too slow.
All out of ammo.
And we are done with the preacher. Okay, one more, and we should be safe. No, there is another one coming. We can also perform takedowns on these guys, and the amount, as you can see, the amount of health we receive is quite big, and it's awesome if you manage to get a takedown on these guys. But they are dangerous if they get close. Luckily for us, they are also they are also pretty slow. And I've got my artillery flare back. Let's get some ammo. And we have just finished the first chapter of this mission, guys. As you can see, pretty easy to complete even on hard difficulty. But except for that truck, which can become a problem if you are not equipped properly. So right now we are safe.
Looks like some of Schweiger's people all dead.
Perfect. This went perfect.
No sign of Schweiger himself. Keep looking.
And here are our results. We only got a bronze medal, but that's okay. It's not really important for our final objective, which is the Platinum Trophy, and for this we need to complete the game on hard mode. So let's see what comes next.
Hello, this is Dr. Schweiger. First, let me apologize for leaving without you. I'm afraid I could delay no further. The storm will appear shortly, and I must get there first. As I'm sure you are now aware, the dead have infested this facility. My team and I were not prepared for such resistance, but have suffered heavy losses.
Okay, so here is the second mission. In this, the second chapter in this mission, actually. So as you can see, I already started to change my loadout. I picked an assault rifle instead of a shotgun, and I'm going with the bulletproof gold perk and the hardened gold perk. But I'm going to change this one over here for the shotgun, because I don't have a shotgun. Pistol, machine gun,
holding out.
Stamina. This is not this is not good for me. No, let's check this this tab. Stamina. I'm going to use this one. And this one is going, I'm going to change it as well with a second chance. I really need this because, and I'm going to explain why. I picked this this perk because there are some enemies with guns, especially one of them will give me a hard time. I got this because I need to make sure if I die, I can revive at least once. I picked this one because I need a larger ammo attachment size. Basically, I need more ammo for my assault rifle. I picked this one for my health to regenerate faster, and this one because there are a lot of enemies in this mission, in this chapter. So these are the parts I'm going to play with. Let's get a medkit. Obviously, that's all we've got. And these grenades should prove useful. Just so you know, for this this chapter, we have the Storm Kill 10 Creepers challenge, which I'm not going to complete simply because I already done that. It's fairly easy. All you have to do is mash one button, and you've got all of them. And I also changed the light in the game. Not sure if you noticed, because I need more light, so I have a better brightness right now. Other than that, this will be a difficult part. I think it is the longest chapter in mission 3, and one of the most difficult. These guys are a pain. So right now I'm going to reset the four breakers. One of them should be here, and here are the creepers. Okay, let's see. So this is the first breaker, and I can hear a creeper. One breaker is down. Let's see what's in this box. Mines. I don't need mines. In this mission, you don't need mines. All you need are grenades, because there is a lot of enemies spawning, and you don't have too much space for maneuver. I'm going to take both of them, and I'm going towards the next breaker. I have to reset, which should be around here, if behind this truck. Yes, here it is. And God, I hate these creepers so much. They are fast. They are deadly. There is another one. Okay. So far, so good. Moving to the next one. Let's see what's in this crate. No. The next one is over here, I believe. Yes. So normally you, for this challenge, whenever you see a creeper, you simply, I don't know, rush towards it and press this button to stomp it. You get those kills quite easy, but they require time, and I want to focus on the objective and on finishing this level as fast as possible. That challenge is not important for me, especially because I already got it. So I am out of ammo right now. Let's see where the next breaker is. Not here. Not on this corridor. This is a labyrinth, just so you know. This is a labyrinth. It looks like I'm moving away from it. Okay.
Creeper.
Damn. Okay, I've got ammo. Great. So far, so good. Now. So let's see. One more breaker. This is the one.
That's it.
Excellent work.
Now here comes the fun part. And this is how you stomp a creeper. Just to show you, for this challenge, this is what you have to do. There is more than, I already got one, but there is more than 10. There are there is a lot of creepers in this level. You won't miss them, that's for sure. So right now we are going towards the research wing, but there is a catch with this research wing.
Flamer.
And that flamer is a pain. If I could get this guy out, perfect. Let's wait for the...
Giant down.
Okay. These giants don't go... don't die too fast, as you can see. I might need to retrace my steps a bit because I'm running out of ammo for my assault rifle. This rifle over here that I'm using, it's I already mastered this weapon, so it has increased damage. But as you can see, basically, although it has increased damage on hard difficulty, it's less important. They are still quite powerful. Okay, so we've got the ammo. I'm going to pick this flamethrower over here and proceed to the research wing. There are several guys we need to kill along the way. Nothing too difficult. So there are these two guys. Perfect. On hard mode, you need to. You need to play this game. I don't know, slow. Let's say slow. You have to pay close attention to every move and every I don't know, every step, because otherwise, if you rush in, you'll most likely die, and this is not your goal, obviously. Oh, this was unnecessary, guys.
Another Schweiger's. No sign of the doc, though.
Okay. We've lost some important health over there. And this health loss might cost us a bit. Man, they die so hard. So we've cleared this area as well. Just so you know, if you are looking for collectibles, there is one over here, the zombie hand. If you need it, I already got it. You can see that I've got all collectibles in this mission. Actually, I've got all collectibles in the game.
I'm low on ammo.
Okay. I'm trying to recover some of the health I've lost. That was not a smart move. And here we are.
Still no juice. There must be another circuit breaker nearby.
Great, so this is where engineers come into play. We've got all of them. Let's get rid of this and head towards our objective. I'm not going to waste too much time here. Man, and I'm running out of ammo as well.
Still nothing. Must be another one to find.
I'm going to start using some of the grenades I have and switch to a pistol. Oh, here is ammo. Perfect. Serious? Okay, so what happened? Why did that? Oh, this is for rifle ammo. God damn it. This is not good, not going well. Great, so I'm trying to get rid of them. That was a very well placed mine, you have to admit. If you shoot the lamps in the in the hands of an engineer, you'll get an explosion, but I'm not doing this all the time, although I could, especially in this level. Okay, only few to go, and then we should be... We should be good. Let's get a takedown.
You'll regret that.
To replenish some of the health points we've lost. And bang in the head. Great. Let's pick up this ammo. This is a trap, I knew, I was aware about it. Let's get some pistol kills. Remember, I still need 200 headshot kills for this this weapon, so I'm trying to get them. Only 50 to go. And then I will have the mastery on this weapon and the trophy for mastering 3 weapons. One of them is the one I'm holding right now. Ooh. What just happened? Where was that guy? More ammo here. Perfect. So right now starts the hardest part in the game, and this part is actually hard because of this area. And what I'm going to do, is to get ready for what's about to happen. I'm going to explain in a moment what I'm going to do. Stay down.
That's it.
Oh, a medkit. This is perfect. Okay, so here it is, guys. What I'm going to do right now. Oh, nice. So what I'm going to do right now is to place some traps over here. The first one will be right over here. And here is why. As you can see, my objective right now is to find 2 thermite charges. And once I find them, these thermite charges will be placed on this door. And I have to protect them, and the zombies will come from here and from here, and that's why I'm trying to set these traps for what's about to happen in the future. This is pretty important because it's a very hard a difficult part to complete, especially on hard difficulty. They will come in large numbers. They are big ones, small ones, creepers. All of them will be after me. So I'm trying to get ready for this. And this part in this area is also kind of annoying. But luckily for me, I can make my stand over here in this. In this tunnel and just shoot them as they come. Let's save some ammo on that weapon because I'm going to need it later. Hopefully I'll be able to get the mastery. As soon as possible. I want that trophy in order to Oh, here is another medkit. I must... I think I have to remember this location. Because I have a very, very difficult opponent upstairs waiting for me. Not sure if you noticed, but in all my walkthroughs, I'm trying to be as and play as strategical as possible. And here is an attachment. This is great. Let me check this room again. This is where you came from, so. And this is where the medkit is. Perfect. Okay, so once we get upstairs, I'm going to find the second thermite charge, and there will be, let's say, an unexpected guest joining us. Take those. I refill this. And we are done here. This is a collectible location. You'll find it here on this table. And here it comes, my friend. And I ruined my takedown on that mob over there instead of using it on this guy. There you go. I've waited so long for you. Seriously? Let me see if I can heal again here. Okay, okay, great, so we've got ammo for both weapons, we've got one of these nasty bugs, and what's more important, we've got this big boy over here. Perfect, I'm going to try and save this for the horde that's about to attack me once I place the second thermite charge. This could make the difference between... oh, no, I'm going to take the MG. This could make the difference between loss and defeat in this mission. This gun over here. Okay, I'm going to place the charge right now. There are some creepers. I'll wait for them downstairs. I'm not going to waste my ammo on them. As you can see, they are pretty fast. Okay, let's do this. Just to get them out of our way. So basically, if you smash all these, you'll get the challenge. That's all you have to do. Pretty easy, pretty boring. Perfect. So let's drop this. Get more ammo. Yes, but we can't. Anyways. And let the fun begin. Thermite set. Defending my position. This is where are the traps are located, or they are gone? No, they are here. Thank you. here they are. I'm going to stab you. Not good.
You again.
And there's a lot of them. So if you are thinking that okay, if you can take them down with so fast with a knife, why don't you do that? Well, because you can. You can actually take enemies down whenever you like. You have to fill that circle with a skull on it in order to perform a takedown. And let me tell you, it's not easy. But I think I still think we are doing pretty good. And right now I'm going to do a maneuver. Yeah, that costed me a lot. Luckily for us, we still have a medkit downstairs. If you remember, in that fridge I've shown you, so we should be fine. And if I could feel this... One more giant and that's it. Oh, just so you know, right now I could get to the save room and but I really wanted to kill that that giant. So this is the end of the chapter. It is a bit long, I know, but we got it on our first try. And remember, this is on hard difficulty, so it's normal to fight more. Perfect. So we are now only two missions away from the end, only two chapters away from the end of this mission, which is awesome. Let's now see what's coming next.
This is Dr. Schweiger once again. As you know, my team and I came here to gather data on the impending hailstorm. But like it as this is, we cannot allow the storm to remain active for long. The countermeasure. I call it the arcane bomb. The material is needed to create this weapon are all in the research lab ahead. I have instructions for assembly with my assistant Carlos. And so I ask you this. Aid my assistant. It is of vital importance. There is no time. I must go online.
You copying this, Bruno? No sign of the doc. But he left us recorded instructions to blow up the health issue.
Schweiger always was the kind to think one step ahead. Well then, get to it. With a bomb to build.
Okay, so we are back. You just saw the dialogue between our good doctor and our zombie fighter over here. So right now we are going to start a mission which, as you can see, has a challenge that simply says that we have to complete the arcane warhead construction in under 12 minutes. So basically, you have to finish this mission in under 12 minutes. It can be done even on hard difficulty if you simply ignore zombies, because you will have to move from one area to another and carry some stuff. I'm not sure if we are going to get it. We are going to try. If we get it, okay. If not, that's okay. What we need to do is focus on this is useless. On finishing the mission. If we can get it in under 12 minutes, that's fine. If not, no, nothing to worry about. I did not change my loadout, it's the same from the previous mission. And right now the chronometer starts. So what we need to do is to gather the firing components. We are going to simply focus on this objective. Let's see if we can get them. Funny fact is that you can basically, as I said, kind of ignore some of the... Oh, here is a powerful weapon. You can ignore some of the zombies that spawn. And just focus on this mission. And we'll see if we can get it in time. We've got one component. I'm also going to place mines as I move around. Hopefully they will step on it, on them, and we can... Here is a trip mine for you. Enjoy. And we've got another component. And the third one should be around here. Somewhere, maybe in this room. Oh, the entrance is on the other side.
Be careful while inserting.
Okay, so we've got them. I'm doing my best to move as fast as possible, but as you can see, the moment you pick up something or you do something, the more zombies will.
Okay. Now what? Just strap it to a rocket.
Will spawn, so eventually there will be a very large number of zombies. Let's start the calibration.
Calibrating now.
I'm going to place another mine.
Target down.
over here. Oh, I was too close. Let's switch to a pistol. That suicider had no chance. Oh, so I have unlocked a new perk. This is awesome. Maybe I am, yes. Oh man. Okay, and now we need to move this. Over here. There are also several crates. Oh, come on. Come on, come on.
Okay, that's done. What now?
Now head to the room above you and activate the radiation induction module. Fuse the core with arcane energy. It's the big red button. You can't miss it.
Copy that, I think.
One over here. Another one over here. And the trip mine over here. We have 6 minutes left. Six, more or less.
Red button. Is that it?
Now we wait for the induction module to charge.
Oh, I totally forgot about these guys. Man, I thought that was okay, let's see what happens next. Right now we have to start the biodistillation process from this panel. And we are stuck with a lot of zombies while waiting for the distillation. Okay. Let's get this med kit. Perfect. And where to put this? In the core.
Triggering another infusion.
And here we go again. This is the same process we have completed earlier. Pretty easy this mission, if you ask me. Nothing. Let me check if there are. We have around 2 minutes left. Oh my god, yeah, I'm going to miss that challenge because of this guy. Totally forgot there is a commander spawning. Let's release the charge.
Biofuels in and infused. It's ready.
Aha, excellent work. Now, all that's left is to take our warhead and attach it to wizard. It is locked doors and I'll open them up for you.
Okay, now we're talking.
Oh, we've got the challenge after all. It was close, obviously, only 30 seconds, but it's good, I'm pretty happy about it, because this way you can actually see that you can complete the challenge even on hard mode. So let's end this chapter. This is obviously shorter than the previous ones. Oh man, where is that commander? There is a commander over here, definitely, and I have no ammo for my pistol, so we are running without ammo and...
Opening the blast doors. Watch out, there might be some zombies lurking in the transport tunnel.
Yes, some zombies. These are some zombies.
Nothing you cannot handle, eh? Once you have installed our brand new arcane core into the missile,
okay. Seriously? More of them. And right now, this is a run for guys. I'm not going to spend any more time with our friends over here. Or I could do that and increase my score a bit. Or not. I'm going to leave them. See another day. Okay, we are done. So this was the third chapter of the second mission, and it will end around now. Perfect. We've got the challenge. This is awesome. We also reached rank 51. Got a trophy. All is going pretty well. So let's start the next and final chapter in this mission. Which is a little more difficult, I believe, than this one.
Oh, well done, and now the bomb is complete. We can finally avenge poor Dr. Schweiger.
Avenge? What do you mean, avenge?
I thought you knew. The doctor, he went to the site to measure the temporal frequency. The hell tower had to be right on top of him. He was destroyed in an instant.
God damn it. Bruno, are you copying this? Schweiger's dead.
Dead? That reckless fool.
Understood. Stay safe, Carlos.
Okay, so right now we are starting the final chapter. This chapter takes place in a huge area, but it's let's first look at the upgrades. Mm-hmm. I was working on upgrading one of, no, not this one, or is it this one? No, I don't think so. It's a sniper rifle. I'm working on unlocking, yes, this is the one, on unlocking all mods for this weapon for future use. This is the one I'm using right now. And how many kills we need? We need, oh, only 27 pistol kills, and that's it. The trophy will be ours. So as I was saying, this takes place in a huge area. The challenge says that we need to complete to kill 20 enemies with artillery strikes. This can be done. Honestly, I didn't do it before, because I wasn't able to find the artillery strike, but if we take some time looking for it, I'm pretty sure it's in the area, and it's very easy to get those artillery strikes, because there is a huge web of zombies. So just so you know, this is a heroic action. If you let this guy attack this NPC, but shoot him before he actually kills the NPC, you complete the heroic action. I already did that, as you can see. It's one of the collectibles. There are 9 in the game you have to finish to unlock a trophy.
Head upstairs and find the lever that activates
incendiary.
Pull it and the bomb will be moved into position. Once you've activated the lever, the noise will alert every zombie in the area. So
I'm just checking.
Sure, the bomb won't work if there's nobody left to fire it.
Yeah. You have an heavy MG over there. Once we start the rocket conveyor, as you can guess, there will be a lot of zombies appearing. Okay, so right now we are going to check some more crates over here. This weapon is very important at the end of this this chapter, because there is a truck that appears and we need to take it down. And this is the area where most of the action takes place. Let's check this as well.
Pulling the lever. Get ready.
And here we go. Honestly, I don't see them. Where are they? Oh, here they are. Come on! I've just waited a perfectly good incendiary grenade trap.
Mine planted.
Let's try to get some pistol kills while there's only a few of them. Now I'm going upstairs. Here you go. So far so good, we are doing good. As you can see, this spot is pretty awesome to defend yourself because they can't go around you. Oh, I totally forgot about this guy. let's grab some ammo and some grenades. Come over here. Right now I could go upstairs and get that heavy MG, and that's what I'm going to do. Or I could simply take out this guy over here and his MG is now mine, which means total disaster for our zombies. Like bread through butter, this is what's happening right now. And I still have one MG upstairs in the bunker. I think we are good right now. Notice that if I'm using the scope on this weapon, this is a vampire scope. It heals me, but it's quite unpractical when fighting a large number of zombies. Otherwise, it's good at healing. Let's see if there are more zombies down here. There is one on the hill.
Got engineers.
And we have a medkit. We might need it later. Great, let's start the conveyor again. And this is why I've kept I don't know, grenade rocket launcher. There is a... There is a truck that's going to appear. Actually, this is a tank, not a truck. So first of all, we are going to aim for those turrets. You see those round orange turrets. I'm going. One. Oh. Hey, come on. Problem is that if we stay here, we are going to be overwhelmed by zombies eventually. So what we are going to do is to start moving down. Here is the tank. Now if I get this weapon over here, I might be able to deal with it. Oh, not good. Luckily, we still have the medkit right close to these stairs. I hope. No, it's gone. This is not good. Oh my God, it's gone. Here is another one. Come on. Okay, I got it. Did we get it? Yes, we did. Yes, we did. Perfect.
Got engineers.
So we've just healed our guy over here, and we also got a new medkit that was on that ledge.
Any idea how long this is going to take?
It should take about half a minute before we are ready for launch. Wait, what's that noise?
Damn it, there's too many of them. We need to launch the bomb now.
No, no, it's killing me. Just hold the line and prepare to fire.
Oh man, these creepers are a pain in the ass. That's what they are. Let's fire the rocket. And that's the end of the mission, guys. This was a walkthrough, a full walkthrough on hard difficulty, and solo play on for the third mission named Meat Locker. I really hope you enjoyed this this walkthrough. It is obviously longer because you know the difficulty is also the highest possible. So this was, as I said, mid-locker mission in Zombie Army 4 Dead War. It is the third part in our complete video game walkthrough. If you enjoyed it, feel free to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe, because we are going to complete the whole game on hard difficulty and in solo in solo mode, and eventually deal with that weirdo Hitler. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you with the next mission, the fourth, which is taking place in a zoo very 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 soon. Thanks for watching again, and have a beautiful week.